Okay, we're gonna finish this after the whole video cut out last time because the battery cut out. So I was completely right in my assessment that the battery isn't very good. So I did do something about it. I didn't just, you know, talk the talk, I walked the walk. And I promptly, like the next day, the very next day, went and bought online some new batteries. But I don't know what step I'm up to. I'm up to this step. So did I actually finish everything? I've got this on the front. And then I was going on about how, like, working out where this goes, and then the whole thing stopped. And then, but now we've got it. It's all worked out. No, we've been doing this. We're up to this step. How come I didn't put that on, but I was doing this step? I don't know. It must have been a pretty crazy time. I'm a bit tired again. It's late. My goodness. So I don't know what to say. I have no idea. So we've done this one, and then this not is not that bit. It's, what's that bit? I really miss the picture that tells you what pieces go where. So there we go. It's too late for me to be doing this. I just wanted to finish this off because it's been sitting on my desk, and I picked up a few interesting things recently that I also want to get onto. This is the last poly bag, I'm pretty sure. But I've got lots of other things to do. I've got two Technic sets to do. So they're going to be good. And then that one goes in the middle, like that song. And then this one goes there. And then I think it just goes there. I hope we don't have to do this twice because it looks pretty tedious. I think I've done something super wrong. It goes on this side. Gotcha. No, that doesn't look right. All right, there's got to be something I've done wrong. So, how come my one doesn't look the same? Oh, there's another piece there that's missing. This bit here. I personally would have preferred it if this piece had been put on here, and then it would have seemed finer. So anyway, that goes there. Yeah. So I bought two batteries plus a charger from one place, and then I bought a single battery from another place, and the double battery and the charger have arrived, but I forgot to charge it up. I got the charger even though the camera, I usually charge off the camera, because, like, why not have an extra charger? I could charge while I'm, that way I can at least, you know, I think I've zoomed in too much, just looking at the camera. I don't know. I honestly can't talk properly tonight. Yes, so lots of arms there, but it's being all done. And so I do have new batteries. I'm not using it. I'm using the current battery at the moment because I haven't got around to changing it. But I did actually charge it up. So, and it has been lasting, oh gosh, at least, I'm not going to say arm again, at least 15 minutes. So I think the battery is still good for that. So I think I can finish this video tonight without having to worry about the battery. But hopefully my battery problems will be fixed. Ah, there it is. My mental being able to concentrate at this time of night. It's not actually late. It's like just after 10 o'clock. But I'm still on daylight savings time, and so it's kind of 11 o'clock, and I normally go to sleep at 11:30, and I'm just being a bit tired recently. But the good thing about me being tired recently is that I haven't actually been so bad. It's like I've definitely improved. I'm back on track. My legs have hurt for the last 2 days. And I feel a bit like, oh gosh, how disappointing. From going on my little hike and getting very enthusiastic about hiking and going more than I was probably up for, or like I was physically up for, but you know, it's that kind of like where your muscles are going to hurt the next day, and it took 2 days to stop hurting. And yesterday I did actually go for a run, which I think helped, but it was quite hard, it was 32 minutes, and the last bit I was a little bit like, oh, I don't think I can finish this. I haven't felt this exhausted in my legs for a long time, but it all fixed up, and today my legs are perfectly fine, and we're all back to things, and I haven't been particularly tired, so that's good. I'm like, finally. And Though I did have a very disconcerting evening. I'm going to talk about my medical problems. I don't really have any medical problems. I'm in pretty good health, I have to say. But I do suffer from low blood pressure sometimes. And so I have to get up very slowly when I do things. And tonight I didn't quite do it. Especially when I have a big backpack on my back and it's heavy. Such as was the case tonight. So we're doing this part here. Well, this looks a bit strange. And I had a quite a bad case of loss of blood pressure when standing up and almost felt like I was going to pass out. But then I felt a bit uneasy after that for a while. So I had to walk around the shop a bit slowly and wondering what would they do if I just sort of like sat down on and collapsed on the ground. It'd be very embarrassing. It's not the kind of thing that I would normally do. But it turned out all fine after a while. But you just got to remember not to get up quickly. That's the moral of the story. And I think that applies to everything in life. Don't get up quickly. Just take your time. So let's just start by reading this thing here, because it's very confusing to do this if you're not paying attention. Maybe I should have zoomed in more, actually. I don't know. I do not know. The trick is just I really have to figure. I really need a better camera with a better zoom. That's the major story. Lots of life lessons. Oh, I can't speak today. Right, found things on the road, and actually we're gonna do one of the things I found on the road at the very end of this video for a special treat because you've been so good. Right, and then this one's going to go there because we're almost finished this. And I think we can push it. We can push the camera. We can push the battery. We're not going to let that battery rule our lives. And I'm just going to get all the pieces together. And so now what am I doing? Oh gosh, what am I doing? Slowly getting my way through Voyager Season 3. Which is a bit strange because I've obviously watched it all before because I know all these ones. And it's like, so of all the series of Voyager that I've watched, Season 3 is definitely one of them, and as in a previous time. So I went and bought a copy on DVD because the library doesn't have Season 3. And I wouldn't have a clue where to stream it. Probably something. But I could just Google it. But anyway, so I thought, well, I'll just buy it because it was a cheap copy on the internet. And so I probably inadvertently probably bought my second copy of Season 3. So that's something. But I have no idea where the other copy is. So this is a true story. This is true and amazing. Amazing true facts. So are these different in some way? They are different in a very subtle way. They are different by these little things that stick out. So these things that stick out have to go inwards by the look of the picture at the bottom, which is interesting. It makes me want to kind of look at the actual representation in the movies and other associated media to see if that's the correct way. I actually had a book from, you know, the early 2000s kind of thingy, before the pre Disney era Star Wars, that had like all the vehicles in it, but I think I may have given it away, or I may have just given away, or actually I threw out this one. It had all the planets in it because it was falling apart and there wasn't any point. So that is that. I don't know how I feel about it. The front seems a little bit, maybe if I change it like that, it looks a lot better. It looked a bit angry before. There was a piece here, wasn't there? There was meant to be a thing. This thing was on here, and it fell off. And I broke everything. I don't know exactly how that goes. So that's a bit. Does fall off. I kind of wish they had a deal with a Technic piece going through the middle of that instead of using one of these, because it's a bit flimsy. But what do you expect for a poly bag? It's pretty good for that. Like I'm satisfied. I think I have to bend it like this to get it. Kind of want it to look like that, just get it right. There you go. I have to say Lego is good for posing things like that. That actually stands up fine. That actually falls over fine, but just exactly the way that I think matches the character of the film. So, how come you stood before? Oh, who cares? Anyway, what did I do with it? I've lost it. Oh no. It was going to be so exciting. Well, that's a letdown. It was in my hands not long ago. It was another one of those silly countdown things, and I misplaced it. So we won't be doing that, after all, because I have no idea where it is. So yes, but anyway, I found a countdown thing on the road, which I thought was a bit strange. Come on, it was here. I know it was here. I must have done something weird with it. Here it is. So we'll do this really quick. So I found this on the road. So remember, I did a whole bunch of these, and none of them were exciting. Here's the shelves. This one is not going to be exciting, but we're going to do it because it was free, because it was on the road. And it makes no sense, because it looks like, obviously, it's been, you know, it hasn't been run over by a truck, but it was in the gutter. But it had obviously been dropped there just recently or something, because like, I go past there all the time. And it's like, why? Why was this there? Why? How did? What was the story behind it getting there? Because these haven't been sold, given away in the supermarkets for well over a month, I think. Maybe even two. So who would have an unopened one that they would drop on the road tonight? I don't know. It was not too far, like within a kilometre of an actual countdown. I'm going to have to do this quick because the camera says it's going to die. We have to believe it. So what did we get? We got this, and we got this, and we got this thing, and I don't know how to put them together. We can't talk about it because there's nothing to say. That goes over the top, like that or something. No, that goes. Oh, I got it. We can do this. It's gonna cut out. It goes that like that, and I don't think I've actually had that one before. And then you can get your delicatessen items or other assorted things that you have to ask someone nicely to put in a little plastic bag for you. So thanks for what it's a meat. It's the meat one. Since I'm not a meat person, there's a sticker though. The stickers can just go that way. Thanks for watching. Like, share, subscribe, and pew 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 pew. Whatever. Bye.